Okay, this is a response to their video up there once I figure out how to do it. The buddy who's recording, Miles, he's one of my buddies, and we had a little dispute over American versus Canadian high schooling because it really pisses me off. Big time. In Canada, we have to take a literacy test, okay? And it is such a big deal. We take a mock literacy test before the literacy test. And if you don't do 75% on the mock literacy test, you get put into an after-school class. Mandatory. So that you can pass the literacy test. And I don't mean a 50% pass. No. The literacy test in Canada is taken during your second year of high school. And you have to get a 75%. If you do not get a 75% or higher on the real literacy test, you do not graduate high school until you do. No certificate for you until you do. That's how much literacy is important to Canada. And I have to wonder, if you have so many kids unable to read, do they really deserve their high school diploma? And I know that maybe as a Canadian I shouldn't be as judgmental, or maybe I don't live there so I don't know what's going on. Copy the head movement. But I get really angry over it. My average for last year, because last year's what counts, I took a victory lap. Just means an extra year of high school. Not because I needed to, because I felt like it and I didn't have the money. So I took an extra class. Now this year I'm maintaining an 84 average. Pretty damn good, 84% out of 100. Not that hard to maintain. Well, it is hard, and I do a lot of work, but the marks that are going out to colleges and universities for me are my marks from last year, my grade 12 year. Okay, because that's when I took cyber arts and everything like that. For those of you who know where I'm bound off to, some of you might. And basically, my average last year was about like a 75, which isn't the best. It's not that bad, but it's not the best. And in Canada, 75 average generally means don't even try for university. Don't even bother. Because the chances of you getting in, miracle. So, and we pay $95. Well, not for university. For college to apply, you pay $95 and you get to apply for five colleges. For university, you pay something like 100 and something. So why waste the money if the chances of you getting in are like why bother? So, but while having a session with my guidance counselor, because you had to have a talk with your guidance counselor about your future. He said if I really desperately wanted to go to university, I could always go to the America. I say the America because I feel like it. The US. Now, the US has one of the most popular, has the most popular universities, aside from England and Oxford, because they have Oxford. But the US has very popular universities, very accredited universities. People see that on a resume and they go, "Oh wow, you're a genius." They do. I'm not going to give them that. But I have to wonder if I can't get into a normal Canadian university with a 75 average, like something like Waterloo, which, unless you're Canadian, you're just kind of like, eh. Unless if you're Canadian, you're like, "Oh great." And living in the general lower province, lower eastern province area, you're like, yay. Anywhere else, you're like, yeah, okay. But that's what makes me mad, is that if I can get into these big names and big universities in America with a 75 average, how low are their standards? Has the poor US have a population that's diminishing and it challenges so much that they have to lower their standards? Or is it just that the education systems are so different that I end up working harder than the Americans? If so, that pissed me off. That makes me very mad. I don't care how dumb you are. Well, no, because that's not the right thing to say. Scratch that. I don't mean that. I don't care what country you live in. That's what I mean. I think we should all have the same education standards. I think everyone should have to take a literacy test. I think it's the best thing. Now, it's a pain in the butt, and a lot of people get, like, it's kind of useless, but you shouldn't be allowed to pass high school if you don't know how to read. No! Let alone get a job. I think, how? It makes me so angry, that's all. I just get really angry. And yes, I'm still college bound because I don't want to move.